Vegas, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why we ain't never got a suffer, made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. I like cash money, yeah, baby, I'm a stunner. I'm a boss, I can do what I wanna. Your last was a dude, boy, that wasn't running. Made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter. Shot him to the moon, we ain't never going under. Hits on hits, I'm a old town slugger. Why after why we ain't never got a suffer, made it to the top floor, but we started from the gutter.
Had to take stairs to the top floor. Every that slept been done for. Got a few bands.
Downtown between Brush Street and I-375. That's where we're located in the heart of Detroit at Ford Field, which first opened back in 2002. Both teams emerging from the Ford Field tunnels just a short time ago. And, of course, the loudest cheers were reserved for the hometown Lions. They're set to go as they will match up with the Arizona Cardinals. Just about time to rock as Toe gets ready to meet Leather. And we are underway from Ford Field. And this is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And he'll be brought down shy of the 20, so the decision to bring it out of the end zone, not a good one. So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. First carry for James Conner. And he'll be stopped up at the line of scrimmage with a flag down. Let's check on the call. That hold coming from the middle of the line, the center.
And it's difficult for him because sometimes you've got people right over you, and as soon as you snap it, trying to get your hands up and block them, you can be a little bit late getting it done.
Play fake, Murray. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. And that is incomplete. Took a shot there on first down, but he couldn't reel it in.
And that may have been incomplete, but he reminds me so much of when my dad used to take me to the baseball stadium and watch the home run hitters in batting practice. I'll get to the stadium early just to watch this kid throw it. He can throw it out of the stadium.
And this one also slow in developing as he's maybe getting back here to the line of scrimmage, but not much more than that. No gain on the play this time, and it'll be a third and long situation coming up. Play action, it's Murray. This one complete to Christian Kirk. And he'll have this past the 30 prior to going out of bounds.
For this defense, CD, and going up against Kyler Murray here, what's the secret to keeping him in check?
Having better athletes than him, which is really unrealistic. So I go way back in football. They used to have a coverage called the umbrella coverage with four defenders back deep. Now you want to try and move that umbrella up front with Kyler Murray, kind of surround him and keep him hemmed into the pocket, because if he breaks out, he's going to hurt your defense in a big way with his legs. And a lot of times these plays, they either go for nothing or they go for big yardage. And here, they got to the outside, turned it upfield, and ended up getting a nice little gain out of it.
Second down and 3. To throw is Murray. And this will be swung out here for Conner. And he'll get up near the 45. They'll spot it at the 44.
And I like the idea here. Get the ball in his hands, even if it's in the passing game. 3 catches a week ago, and he does a nice job here to pick up yardage.
Here's Conner on the read option. And he's going to get it across the midfield stripe into Lion territory.
A good run there on first down, and it'll leave them with a second and two. Here's Murray. Screen pass to Connor. And that play will go nowhere. Losing yardage back near midfield at the 49. It'll be a loss of two, maybe three on the play. And all of a sudden here, it's third down. Now Murray off play action. Buying time to his left. He's got a man on the crossing route. That's Moore. And all the way down to the 10-yard line. A huge play there for Arizona.
We expected this defense to be tested by this passing game coming into this one. And there's an example on this first possession of the game.
Murray now on first down. Escaping the pressure right. And he'll just throw this one over in the way of the security crew. Incomplete here.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
That's complete to Edmonds, his running back. Touchdown, Cardinals! Chase Edmonds, his second touchdown on the season. And the Cardinals take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. For the extra point, and it's now a 7-0 game. After the touchdown, out is Prater to kick. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Fake the give. Now gone. That's into the hands of Khalif Raymond. And he takes this up to the 40-yard line before being corralled.
Defense gives up a touchdown on the opening drive. Offense, you got to want to get out there and get those points back right now.
And that's a sharp throw there to get this drive off to a good start. So quickly all the way up at the 40-yard line. First carry for DeAndre Swift. And gets by him, and now a little daylight. And he's got some space here. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. A big play there out of the running game. So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for first and 10. A play fake for Swift. Now Goff. Throw caught by Raymond. Touchdown! Khalif Raymond. Touchdown number 12 on the year. And the Lions are an extra point away from tying this thing up. Extra point by Seibert, up and good. And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play. Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he's only going to make it to the 13-yard line and no further. Now we're going to get a stoppage here as we've got an injured Cardinal on the field. We'll check on his status when we get back. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they had to go the length of the field last time out to get into the end zone. And with this starting field position, they're going to have to pretty much do it again.
And I think the thought...
Try to force it to Hopkins, and it's intercepted. Picked by Jeff Okuda. And he will bring it.
interception return for a Lions touchdown.
What you just saw there, first round talent, second year, even more success. A pick six for a touchdown.
And a great play. And it's tough for these guys, you've told me before, to adjust in the secondary as a first-year guy. So that sophomore season is big for them.
They really start to expand the playbook for them even more. Sometimes they dumb it down a little bit to make them comfortable year one. By year two, they should have all the nuances. And now they've adjusted to the speed of NFL play as well.
Showed right there. Here comes a return from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And they gave up the pick six, and now they'll be looking to right the ship here. Now, as a quarterback, are you a little more cautious this go-around?
You should be, just because after what you gave up. But you can't be so cautious as to just really take things in, and now you're not going to play loose enough to give your team a chance to score. But you still have to be careful, because those defensive guys, I know the reputation defense guys can't catch. All evidence to the contrary on that last possession, though.
Through one corner, 14-7, our score. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Murray a give. This is Connor. And he'll be tackled just past the 35 at the 36. Tackled there by Alex Anzalone.
That's a really nice, tough run inside, and they gained 5 yards on it. And to be frank about it, most offenses don't expect to get 5 yards on a play call like that. So when they do, they go back to their huddle with a little pep in their steps. They're starting to think that they're starting to dominate the line of scrimmage.
Connor going to get it again on second down. And this carry not as productive. He swallowed up at the line of scrimmage. And he got off the end there very quickly to make that play.
Yeah, it was almost like the bullet train, wasn't it? I mean, just zoom, quick, quick, quick. And what a terrific play, holding them to no gain.
For the Lions, an extra DB in the game now here on third down. Murray now to throw. On the screen, this is Edmonds. And he's able to get this one out closer to midfield across the 45.
Another catch for him there on this drive, Brandon. It looks like they're going to utilize him out of the backfield any way they can. And that time, they pick up a first down. So now on defense, do you assign a man to him and try and cover him before he gets going?
On first and 10, here's Murray. Going deep for Hopkins. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Thus far, they've been able to move the line of scrimmage very well in the running game. Almost felt like they said in the huddle, can you guys pass protect? Let's take a big shot downfield. Didn't get it on that one, but they may come back to it again.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Edmonds running out of the shotgun. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for him. Show him that you're supposed to get the football.
Throwing on first down is Murray. They'll go out to the flat for Edmonds. That catch good for only a couple.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
To throw again on second down. Murray flushed out right. All in all, no gain on the play, and it'll bring up third.
Well, he strung it out as far as he could, and I like the fact that he kept his eyes downfield, but he finally ran out of time and room. But I'll take that over forcing it downfield and possibly having it intercepted.
They'll fake it to Connor. Now Murray being chased out left. Green with a catch left side. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
And this has been a nice answer to the touchdown drive against them a few minutes ago because they've come out and reestablished the tempo. A nice throw there. And they're putting together a very strong drive as a response.
A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29.
That was a particularly nice play because not only was it his job to force the play inside, he was actually able to fold inside himself and make the tackle ultimately. Very nicely done.
On second and 9, Murray. That's out to the flat for Edmonds. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20.
And they'll use him out of the backfield and sometimes quite a bit. They're just trying to get him touches any way they can. 4 catches a week ago, there's another one right there.
We've hit the 2-minute mark of the second quarter, 14-7. Now on first down. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by Will Harris. And the Lions are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. Maybe I'm wrong, but it looked like even if he had opted to keep that, I don't think there was going to be much to gain.
Seemed like it was perfectly defense. And know what they say, those guys on the other side, they get paid too.
Well, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted. Isaiah Simmons picking it off. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
Well, if you go by the numbers, you'll find as the temperature goes down, so does the passing efficiency. And now that we're in December, even the routine throws are going to be harder for the quarterbacks. And this one, it winds up getting picked off.
They'll run on first down, Edmonds. And he'll lose yardage. Brought down at the 32. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
Now on second and 13, Murray. That's complete to his running back, Connor. Space to run past the 20. And he's all the way down to the 13-yard line.
Well, they've certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
Flush to his right. And he's going to lose a yard or two. Taken down behind the line. The Cardinals going to use the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. After the sack here, second and 11. Here's Murray. That's going to be caught by Kirk for a Cardinals touchdown. Christian Kirk. As the first half is winding down. And the Cards have a chance to tie the game here in the final seconds of the half. Extra point good by Prater. And we are tied here in the second quarter. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken.
The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And we'll see what they want to do. Just 20 seconds remaining here before the half.
Trying to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. That'll be incomplete as the clock will stop with 14 seconds remaining.
The object there was to get the ball to him on a quick slant, see if he could get loose and take one the distance. But the defense was prepared, and incompletion results.
So the incompletion, and now it's second and 10, again from the 25-yard line. Play action. It's gone. He's going to fire one deep, middle of the field. And it's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
Certainly no lack of aggressiveness here. They were hoping for the home run play to get them 6 points. They're hoping for a catch, maybe a call. But they figure they can at least get into field goal range with a completion.
Throwing on third, Goff. And that's to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds. And you see the clock almost empty, so this is likely the last play in the second quarter.
What I love about watching the passing game nowadays is that the one-dimensional receiver is really starting to leave the game. You've got to be able to do it all. Of course, you've got to run fast.
Oh, that's into double coverage and intercepted. Jalen Thompson picks it, and he will be brought down on what will be the final play of this first half. So thanks to the late touchdown, it's a tie ball game here heading to break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And ready to get the party started for the second half. It was an even first half, all tied on the scoreboard. Here comes Khalif Raymond from his end zone. The Lions offense ready to kick off their next drive. They start from scratch here, so to speak. 14 all following the interception last time that led to a score. Well, they've got it first and 10. And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26. Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. Off play action. Here's Goff. Rifles one incomplete. So, Charles, tie game here. What are your keys as we continue to play this second half?
I know people think it's always trite when you say the same things over and over, but they're tried and true in the game of football. Who's going to block better? Who's going to tackle better? In this case, to me, it's turnovers. You've got to take care of the football in order to win the game.
After an incomplete pass on second down, that'll leave them trying to convert. On third and 9, they'll fake the handoff. Now Goff. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And yet again, Goff is intercepted. Got a banker with a pick. And the Cardinals are going to take possession here at their own 16-yard line. Well, that's three picks he's now thrown in this game.
And I know this, the holiday season. Because here we are
season
in December,
of giving.
Right? It is the season of giving. Maybe for his own sake, after the game, he may have to announce that he's donating certain amounts to charity for each interception that he threw.
Trey Flowers there on the tackle. The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. Now a give to Edmonds, and he's taken down. It's a gain of 3 from the 17 to the 20.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense, and guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time, but you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
Murray going to throw. Forced out to his left. He'll swing that out to Edmonds. That's going to bring up fourth down, only a gain of two there.
He was out there waving his arms, and when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is, because you got to get his attention, because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
Gets around him. And he gets this to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. A great return there of 22 yards. And the Lions will have excellent field position here as they take over first and 10. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive.
They'll try and set up the screen to Swift.
And he got blown up, losing yardage on the play back at the 44. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
Second and 11 now.
Out of the gun, Goff. He's going to float this one deep right side. Got a man. It's caught inside the 10. Touchdown, Detroit.
Khalif Raymond.
His second touchdown of the afternoon.
And the Lions on just two plays have taken the lead.
Extra point by Seibert up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away.
This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone.
And he's able to get this across the 20, but not by much, as he's marked down officially at the 21. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And a tight game after punting last time. See if they can get something going on this drive.
As they head to the field now, with the game this close, you've got to feel there's a sense of urgency for them going on offense right now. But they have to do it without letting panic creep in and affect their play.
Second down at 7.
Running left, here's Edmonds. And he'll get this one up to the 26. Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about 5.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description, because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
And the Lions going with an extra DB here on third down. Here's Murray as he sets to throw it. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
It's always a goal, and it's really nice defensively when you can rally to the football and make sure there's enough contact to force an incompletion.
Force an incompletion and force another punt. Here's Andy Lee now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. So possession goes over here on the punt, and the Lions will take over. The Detroit offense ready to begin their drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go-around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
And all the way down to the 29. A big play there on the catch and run.
We have seen big plays from both quarterbacks throughout this game, and there's another one right there. Going back and forth, almost like two excellent guitar soloists trying to top each other with each additional play.
A little bit of daylight on that first down run sets him up nicely. 8 yards on the carry.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
Now a play fake, and it's Goff. And he'll be taken down at the 2 yard line.
Boy, how about the speed with which this offense can get down the field? It's taking them no time at all to get down here. And now they're set up with a first and goal.
They'll run with Swift. And he pushes forward but comes up short of the goal line as he'll get a yard down to about the one. We're off to the fourth quarter here in week 15. Happy holidays to all. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Second and goal from the one. Swift again. And this time they were waiting for him as he'll be knocked down before he can get back to the line of scrimmage. A second down play results in a loss of 2 yards. A lot of tired bodies on that field, but this is a big play, third and goal. Swift. They push forward, but I don't think it's enough. He's going to be about a yard short. He needed three. He got two. Now that'll set up an interesting situation here on fourth and a yard. They'll try it now with Swift. And I'm not sure he got there. Did they stop him? They did. They stop him up short on fourth and goal from the one. And this Cardinal defense comes up with a goal line stand. Ready to go with their next drive and at the line, the Cardinal offense. And can they take advantage? Their defense got the fourth down stop, and now they're hoping to find the end zone. A field goal wouldn't be enough to erase this fourth quarter deficit. It'll be Edmonds to begin the drive. And he'll take this up to about the 7 or 8 yard line.
Well, both teams practiced this situation, and this time the guys on offense won, and in a very nice way. What a run from that position on their own goal line.
Gave them some good breathing room.
I wonder now, do you still stack the line of scrimmage, or do you play normal defense? They may have backed them off with that run.
Yards remain for second down. A give running right is Connor, and he's going to be taken down shy of the 10, right around the 9 yard line. Only a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down.
When we talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
Third and two, and here's Murray. And able to find Kirk complete. And he is going to have a Cardinals first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the fourth. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. On first and 10 is Connor. And he's going to have just a couple here with a marker on the field as well.
So that time they get the tight end on the hold.
Normally, he's a pretty good run blocker, but this time he just didn't get his arms extended and let go quickly enough. The flag came out as a result.
Throwing now is Murray. He'll get that one complete to Connor. And he'll get to the 29-yard line, brought down there. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
With all the success they've had throwing the football as a pass rusher, you know you've got to come hard when you see him drop back to throw. So I really like this call to counteract that pass rush with a screen. It turns into positive yardage. A lot of times the offense says, just replace the rusher with the ball, and it turns into a good play.
And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on, third down.
The frustration is definitely setting in because they've thrown it to him over and over, unable to come up with a catch thus far.
I think he knew he would have his challenges against his secondary. I don't think he saw a goose egg at this point in the game.
Play action. Now it's Murray. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. The drive continues as they search for a tying touchdown. Here's first and 10. Throwing again, Murray. He'll get this to his running back, Edmonds. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So the Cardinals, they've got the football here as we get you reset. They come up on a first and 10, desperately needing a score here on what could be their final drive. And Murray gets this into the hands of Edmonds. They'll go for a gain of 7, and it'll be second down. Murray to throw. And this throw incomplete. Well, the defender all over him that time, but it's going to lead to third down. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You having to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
Here comes play number 9 now as they come up on a 3rd and 3. Murray a give to Edmonds on the option. And he's going to have the first down yardage to the 35. They're making steady progress, but I see your face. You're worried about that clock.
I'm worried about the clock, and at some point, you have to have a splash play in there as well.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's 1st and 10. Back to throw, Murray. And he finds his tight end, it's Ertz. And he is out of bounds inside the 30. Give him 9 there on the first down completion.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give him a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
And just a yard to go here on 2nd down. To throw is Murray. Finding Ertz again.
Okay, there's 3 timeouts left, right?
Think you got to use one here, don't you?
No doubt about it. I'd use one right here.
Now Murray. Oh, no, lost the football. And this is scooped up by the Lions. He's at the 50. The 30. 10. And he is not quite going to make it all the way in. They'll mark him down right about the 1-yard line.
And they were hoping to get down there, get the score, and get this thing into overtime. How deflating.
Absolutely. I mean, let's face it, heartbreaking. They had an opportunity, had a chance, and probably were feeling pretty
good. And he's across for the late touchdown. And in the final seconds, that one should just about put a capper on this game.
So they brought the extra bulk in down on the 1 yard line, and they're able to push this one across.
Yeah, I can just see your face right now because I know we're mind melding on this one. Coach Madden would love this. Power football, hat on a hat, chest to chest, driving forward, touchdown.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point. He's got it as they double up the lead. This one's now 28-14. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. No run back here, down to a knee, and this drive will start at the 25. Ready to go with their next drive, and at the line, the Cardinal offense. They can't do much at this point, partner. This one is going to go down in the loss column.
You don't make up for what has happened during the game in this sequence here. Maybe you hand it off and let someone run the ball if you so choose. But otherwise, just kneel down, call it a day, and try and prepare going forward.
And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. So this one's over. It's a win for the Detroit Lions. And it was their defense that really made the statement after the break. They pitched the second half shutout.
Yeah, think about the team that just got vanquished. They did score in the second quarter. Do you think they thought at all that that would be their last point of the game?
No, but what a second half. The adjustment, whatever they did in the locker room, it certainly worked.
It certainly did, and you're exactly right. Whether it was an adjustment, whether it was just more focus on what they planned to do going in, whether they just played better, whatever.
Don't want your bro, it was for show, just so you know. We just wanna get lit. We just wanna get lit.